Then tomorrow we'll bring one good notebook also. Good evening. Let us start AS21 accounting. This is consolidated financial statement. In your book, you'll find this is chapter number 6. The same presentation which is appearing on the screen will be appearing in your booklet also. So you don't have to write anything. But there are a few questions which we will solve. That time you will write, okay? Anything extra if you want to write, you can write. Okay, so we'll start consolidated financial statement. Okay, so first we'll start with AS21, consolidated financial statement. In the intermediate course also, they have introduced this topic, but very briefly. You may be either from IPCC course or intermediate course. IPCC course, this chapter was not there. But intermediate course, this chapter is there, which of course people keep it for option. Now, what is the meaning of consolidated financial statement? So, suppose this is one company, holding company, we'll call it say H Limited, and this is one more company which we will call S Limited. Holding company is holding more than how much percentage? 20 or 50? More than 50% in S Limited, which means in technical words, H Limited controls S Limited. Because if you are holding more than 50% share in a company, you can take all decisions, at least all important decisions, okay, because most of the decisions will be based on voting, like a democracy. And if you have more than 50% vote, so you can get all the general resolutions passed. So S Limited controls. So what we do in consolidated financial statement, we will prepare balance sheet, P&L account, cash flow statement, which will add the assets and liabilities, if it is a balance sheet, of the two companies. If it is a P&L account, then we'll add the income of the two companies. If it is a cash flow statement, we'll prepare the combined or total of the cash flow of holding and subsidiary company. For example, if suppose fixed asset of this company is 100, fixed asset of subsidiary is 50, so how much will be the fixed asset of the group? This is called group also, group balance sheet. So fixed asset of the group will be 150. This way we will prepare the consolidated financial statement. It's not very difficult, you just have to add. Right. Of course, there will be some adjustments given to you to test your basic understanding of accounting also. Like fixed asset revaluation adjustment can come, depreciation adjustment can come. Okay. So those adjustments are given to test your understanding. But otherwise, it is a simple consolidation of assets and liabilities, income and expense, cash flow of the group entities. Okay. In your exam, mostly consolidation of balance sheet is asked. So out of 10 exams, 9.5 exams, balance sheet consolidation question is asked. Okay. Very rarely consolidation of P&L account or cash flow statement is asked. So we will focus mostly on the consolidation of balance sheet. So now the heading is, what is the need for consolidation? why we need to consolidate parent company, that is holding company, and its subsidiary company. Any answer? Suppose you are an investor, you have 100 crore rupees to invest. Which of these three balance sheet you would look at to take the decision? Only H Limited or the group balance sheet? Because of course, when you invest in H Limited, which has invested a significant chunk in S Limited, we need to understand the performance of subsidiary also. We need to understand the performance of subsidiary also. That gets reflected in the consolidated financial statement. Is it right? So, as a group, what is your net asset? What is your revenue? What is your profit? That we will get to know only if I look at the CFS, not at the separate financial statement. This we will call SFS, separate financial statement, or standalone financial statement. This we'll call CFS, consolidated financial statement. So investor is interested in understanding, as a group, how much this company is earning, how much is their net worth. Is it right? So that is the reason we prepare the consolidated financial statement. It's basically for the investors. And also now, because of the requirement of the law, Companies Act says you have to prepare CFS. Is it right? The SEBI or the stock exchanges also say, in case if you want to get listed on the stock exchange, then you have to prepare the CFS. And any ordinary investor also, when he invests in the company, he would look at the consolidated figures. So I have written three or four points. Why do we consolidate? It is not an exam question, but we'll start from the basic thing. Why we need to consolidate? Why we are putting so much energy on preparing consolidated financial statement? Why don't you just give him two balance sheet? Take H Limited, take S Limited, you do yourself whatever you want. Not everybody is accountant like you. Is it right? So therefore, we have to give them consolidated financial statement. So the first reason is to present the result of operation and financial position of a parent and its subsidiary as if the group were a single enterprise. Consolidated balance sheet also looks like a separate financial statement only. You will have asset, liability, income, expense, everything. But one more item comes in the CFS, which is not there in the separate financial statement. What is that item? Minority interest. In case if you are not holding 100% of the stake in subsidiary, some stake will be held by others. So the value of the stake held by others is called minority interest in AS 21 and non-controlling interest in Ind AS 110. So when you are solving AS 21 problem, what will you write? Minority interest. When you are solving 110 based problem, what will you write? Non-controlling interest. Why? There is a difference because this word minority is very sensitive in India. Okay, so let us avoid it. Second, CFS are more meaningful than separate financial statement. As an investor, we are more interested in CFS than SFS. As a group, what is the income, net worth, cash flow? That is what we are interested in. When we are putting hundreds of crores of rupees in a company, we would be more interested in CFS. Point number three, financial performance and net worth of the group as a whole will be known to the stakeholders. As a group, what is their net worth and performance is more important than separate statement. So those who are the stakeholders in a company, name some stakeholders in a company. Shareholders. Both equity and preference, lenders like bankers and debenture holders and financial institutions. Is it right? Management of the company itself, employees of the company, government, these are the stakeholders. They are interested in CFS. it is beneficial for shareholders and creditors of the parent company. And now under Companies Act also, preparation of CFS is mandatory. You may not be knowing that under the old act, CFS was not mandatory. Only the listed companies were preparing CFS. But now even unlisted company will prepare CFS if it has a subsidiary company. There are few exceptions, that is when CFS is not required, but that is not we are going to cover right now. Even the IFRS requires consolidation. So when Indian companies would raise funds from abroad, what the foreign investor would demand? CFS. They will not ask SFS. So if Flipkart has to raise funds from Walmart, which statement they must have looked upon? CFS. Not SFS. Is it right? Foreign investors want CFS. So therefore now in India CFS is also mandatory. Listed companies are also required to prepare CFS because stock exchange requirement is there. Now the next question is general knowledge question. What is the advantage of holding a subsidiary company kind of business structure? See, one possibility is there are two companies A and B. A should absorb B. A should simply absorb B and just A Limited should remain in existence, wind up, liquidate B Limited. Other possibilities, let B also continue to exist, only acquire shares. Let B also remain in existence, only acquire the shares. In any case, you can control B Limited in this way also, that is absorption, which you have studied, okay, in intermediate, or this way, that is your consolidated, let us call it parent subsidiary relation. Which is better? This is better. Why? We'll see the reasons. Is it right? Mostly companies don't liquidate the other company. Practically, they will keep B also in existence. You can control B through shares also. Suppose you acquire 100% shares, it is as good as you can take any decision that you want. Okay, so let us read the reasons for holding a subsidiary way of creating a business group. Tomorrow you also have to do this, okay? So this is better than absorbing another company. First reason is separate identity and legal entity of a subsidiary company is maintained. And as such, they maintain their own goodwill also. So this will appear as a separate legal entity, A. B will appear as a separate legal entity. They will have their own independent goodwill also. In this case, if you absorb B, probably the existing goodwill of B would be lost forever. Is it right? So, and goodwill is one of the most important assets in the business. Public is not aware about the existence of combination. In the eyes of public, A is one entity, B is another entity. Actually, in substance, they have become one entity only, but public is not aware. Because if you merge the two company and make it one, it becomes a very big company in the eyes of public. It looks like a monopoly company. Do you like monopoly? No. Do you like Indian Railway? Louder. No. Why? It's a monopoly. You don't have a choice. But you like Indigo Airline, Jet Airline, you have a choice there. So, in this mode of business, you don't create a monopoly. At least in the eyes of public, there is no monopoly element, because if there is monopoly, they will complain to the government. One fine day, government will nationalize that company also. Is it right? Or can pass certain judgment because it looks like you are killing the competition. So competition law will come into force. So that is better. Let public know as if these are two different companies. And this is one important advantage of holding and subsidiary structure. Less cost is involved. Why? For absorption, you have to pay for 100% of the the company acquired. Then only you can absorb it. But for subsidiary, you can acquire with only 51% also. Like for example, Walmart acquired Flipkart. How much percentage they have acquired? Say 77% or something. So they could get the same benefit with paying only for the 77% of the value of the company rather than for 100%. In fact, they could have acquired only 51% also and got the control over the company. Okay. Whereas in absorption, amalgamation, the consideration paid is really very high compared to this mode of acquisition. And due to separate identity, loss can be carried forward for income tax purpose after holding company device also. These are two different entities. Each of them will carry forward their own losses and set off. And financial position and profitability of subsidiary company can also be ascertained. First, both companies will prepare their separate financial statement. So it is like your branch accounting or departmental accounting. Each branch or each department profit we used to find out. Why? For decision making purpose. Now here also separate subsidiaries financial statement will be prepared. So each quarter we will know, each half year, each year end we will know what is the performance of the subsidiary. And if it is loss making, which you will get from the balance sheet and P&L account of subsidiary, you can dispose it off also. Even disposal of a subsidiary is much easier compared to selling one of your businesses. If you absorb a company, merger, demerger is a more complicated, lengthy legal process compared to selling the shares of a company. You have to go to the stock exchange and you have to sell the shares. That is much easier process. So that is my point number six. If desired, the control of subsidiary company can be given up easily through the stock exchange. What are the disadvantages? General understanding only, not for exam. First is possibility of fraudulent manipulation of accounts, especially if the accounts of various companies are made up to different dates. What is this? Sometimes, but not necessarily. Holding company and subsidiary company may enter into transactions which otherwise they would not have entered into. Is it right? Like in case any of you have the experience of auditing a big group company, you will find holding company purchases goods at 100 rupees. Sales to subsidiary company at 250 rupees. And then subsidiary company sales to customer at 125. So in the books of holding company, how much profit they will book? 150. 150 profit. In the books of subsidiary, they will book a loss of 125. And it happens. But when you prepare the group balance sheet, 100 cost will appear, 125 selling will appear. This intra-group transaction gets eliminated in the process of consolidation. So only the transaction with outsiders will appear in the CFS. Then next is inter-company transactions are often entered into to suit the control of the holding company. This example on the screen above, cost is 100, sold at 250, which otherwise in the market it is selling for 125. Reverse also happens, which I have also observed in some company. The subsidiary company is a manufacturing company. It manufactures goods at 200 rupees. Then it is asked by parent company to sell it to parent company at 100 rupees. And then parent company will sell it to customer at 300 rupees. So who would book the loss here? Subsidiary. And parent company will make the profit. So subsidiaries companies outside shareholders don't enjoy the dividend because they don't let subsidiary show the profit only. So that is the third point. There is a danger of operation on minority shareholders. Because if this kind of structure they design, subsidiary will not be able to book the profit. So how can you pay the dividend? So this minority stakeholders, they suffer. And shareholders of holding as well as subsidiary company never know what is the true and fair profit of the subsidiary company. Because transactions are designed in such a manner that you don't really know what is the genuine profit of this individual companies. These are the disadvantages. Now, which are the accounting standards which deal with investments? So you'll see on the screen there are four accounting standards I have written, AS 13, 21, 23 and 27. So what is AS 13? Accounting for investment, simple. AS 21, CFS, 23, accounting for investment in associate in CFS, which is also a part of your syllabus. And AS 27, financial reporting of interest in joint venture. AS 13 is not a part of your syllabus in detail. These three standards are there. Now, where it is applicable? AS 13 is applicable for all investment in separate financial statement. All investment made in separate financial statement. AS 21 is only applicable in consolidation of subsidiary with the parent. So it is applicable in consolidated financial statement when you have a subsidiary company. AS 23 is applicable when you have an associate in CFS. What is the difference between subsidiary and associate? Over subsidiary we have control. Over associate we have significant influence. Over associate we have only significant influence. Subsidiary we generally hold more than 50% share. Associate we hold more than 20 but up to 50% share. Okay, so we have less control over associate. Earlier, for knowledge purpose, earlier AS23 was applicable. Earlier AS23 was applicable only when AS21 is also applicable to the company. But now, since Companies Act 2013, even if AS21 is not applicable, AS23 is still applicable. So AS23 will be applicable irrespective of whether a company has a subsidiary or not. Right? And same thing about AS27. AS27 is joint ventures basically. It is applicable in CFS. In the case of JCE, what is JCE? Jointly controlled entity. Jointly controlled entity. Is it right? It's called jointly controlled entity. Means two venturers have invested in a third company and that third company is called jointly controlled entity. Bharti Exa. Okay. Tata Docomo. These are jointly controlled entities. But if it is a JCO or JCA, then it is applicable in separate financial statement. Now what is JCO? Jointly controlled operations. Jointly controlled operation. If you take an Airtel mobile phone, you get credit from ICICI Bank. Is it right? But ICICI Bank is an independent entity. Airtel is a telecom service provider. But they are selling the product together to a customer so that both of them benefit. So that is a jointly controlled operation. Company remain independent. Goods are sold to the customer as if it is one product only. So jointly controlled operations. Okay. And jointly controlled asset. Like for example, there is a mobile tower which may be jointly owned by Idea also and Reliance Jio also. So tower is one, owners are two. A simple example is a building which may be owned by two parties and they give it on rent. So that is jointly controlled asset. So these are the three standards dealing with consolidation. 21 for subsidiary, 23 for associate, and 27 for joint ventures. Joint ventures as per AS 27 are of three types: JCO, JCA, JCE. For JCO and JCA, separate financial statement, and for JCE, consolidated financial statement will be applicable. More about these two standards in detail after we complete AS 21. Now, what is the benchmark here as far as shareholding percentage is concerned? More than 50%. For AS 21 to be applicable, more than 50% of the share in voting power is required, which is basically equity share. Okay. And what about this? 20 to 50%. 20 is also applicable, up to 50. The moment you exceed 50, 21 will become applicable. And what about the 27? 0 to 50%. 0 to 50%. Now then you should ask me the query, if you are holding 20% stake in a company, which standard is applicable, 23 or 27? So the answer is whether there is a joint venture agreement between the parties or not. So if there is a joint venture agreement, 27 is applicable. If there is no joint venture agreement, 23 is applicable. Of course, if you are putting crores of rupees in a company, you would enter into some kind of agreement if it is a joint venture. Is it right? There are proper legal documents. So practically, you will be able to identify it is a joint venture or associate. Associate, you purchase 20% stake from the stock market, and you are a investor and the other party becomes your associate. There is no joint venture agreement in AS23. And how do we do the consolidation? They have given names to the method of consolidation. AS21 method of consolidation is called line by line consolidation. I had done one consolidation some minutes back. Fixed asset 100, fixed asset 50, CFS 150. Simple line by line consolidation. Same items appearing in the two balance sheet. Their numbers will be consolidated subject to few adjustments. Okay. And what is the name of the accounting method in AS23? It is called equity method of accounting, which we'll discuss in AS23, not now. And what is the name of the accounting method under AS27? It is called proportionate consolidation method. It is called proportionate consolidation method. So three names for the three types of consolidation. Now for the remaining portion, today, we are only going to discuss AS21. Is it right? What is included in CFS? Like separate financial statement, CFS also has four elements. Balance sheet, P&L account, cash flow statement, notes, and explanatory material that form an integral part thereof. For exam purpose, you will focus more on balance sheet. So now from here onwards, we will start AS21. AS21 has got some important definitions. First is the definition of a subsidiary. What is a subsidiary? As per AS21, subsidiary is an enterprise which is controlled by another enterprise. Controlled by. So they have used a technical word, controlled by another enterprise, and that other enterprise in this standard will be called parent. So we will call parent and subsidiary company. Parent controls, subsidiary is controlled by parent company. So then you should know what do you mean by control. How do we get the control as per this standard? Pay attention, there are two ways to acquire control. Students know only one, the first one. But there is a second method of acquiring control also. What is the first method of acquiring control? The first method is what generally we know, the ownership directly means yourself, one company holding more than 50% share, or indirectly through subsidiaries also. You may not hold share in a company, but your subsidiary may hold more than 50% share in another company, then that third company is also your subsidiary. That will also be consolidated of more than one half of the voting power of an enterprise. So this is the definition as per AS21. Companies Act definition may be different, but we will right now only follow AS21 for the sake of consolidation that is allowed in the exam. So in short, directly or indirectly, if you're holding more than 50% share in the voting power of an enterprise, then you are controlling the other company. You are parent, the other entity subsidiary. Parent will consolidate subsidiary's financial statement with its own financial statement. Now see the example of direct control. This is a direct control. Now direct control questions have been shifted to intermediate level. No thrill, no excitement. Just add the numbers. A Limited holds 60% share in X Limited. More than 50, any number. So this is direct control. Now see the indirect control. Next example. A Limited has a subsidiary. We will call it X Limited. 60% share of X is held by A. X Limited is holding 60% share of Y. So the question is whether Y is a subsidiary of A. So how the consolidation will be done now? Two consolidation will have to do. Because X is a parent of Y. So Y will have to be consolidated with X. Then we'll get a consolidated financial statement of X. That will be used to consolidate A. This type of problem we are going to solve. It is called chain holding problem. Because you have created a chain here. This is a chain holding problem. Very popular in CA final exam. Okay. In one exam, there was one more Z also here. As per Companies Act, now you cannot have more than two layers of subsidiaries. Okay. But in the exam, three layers are also possible. Either you don't answer it by writing a note. Companies Act says only two layers of subsidiaries are applicable. Hence, I refuse to answer a wrong question. Or you solve and come home. Then there are three stages of consolidation. First Z with Y, then Y with X, and then X with A. So what will you do? Leave or solve? Better. Solve. Now this is a more complicated structure. You see, there is a company A. It has two subsidiaries, X and Y. X is holding 30% share in B, and Y is also holding 30% share in B. Through subsidiaries, through two subsidiaries, A is holding 60% share of B. Whether B will be also consolidated with A? Yes. B is also subsidiary of A. So you have to consolidate X, Y and B's. All three balance sheets will be consolidated with A. Do not make the following mistake. What is the mistake? Student will say 60% of 30%. 18. 60% of 30%, 18. 18 plus 18, 36. B is not a subsidiary. Is the answer right? No. Let us assume there is a annual general meeting of B is getting held. Now how the voting will be done? A Limited will instruct X Limited that you vote for director ABC. So how many votes X has? 30 votes. Then A will instruct Y, you also vote in favor of director ABC. How many votes Y has? 30 votes. So 60 votes would be casted in favor of director ABC will get elected. Is it right? So A controls B. In this example, A controls B. How to solve such question? When we'll come to that, we will solve. One more indirect control problem. Here A is directly holding 60% share in X. So X is a direct subsidiary. In this example, there is a company Y where 30% shares are held by A directly and 30% shares are held by one of its subsidiaries, X Limited. So 30 plus 30, together A directly 30 and indirectly 30. So 60% shares of Y are held by A and X. Y is also a subsidiary. This is another favorite question of your institute. Is it right? This is method one, directly or indirectly through voting power. Is it necessary that you must hold the share to control the other company? As per AS21, not required. You can control the other company by method two also. That is control of the composition of the board. Control of the composition of the board in the case of a company, if it is a corporate body, or the corresponding governing body in case of any other enterprise, so as to obtain economic benefit from its activities. Now, since you are so attentive, tell me whether this line which I am highlighting right now was mentioned in control 1. Control 1 definition, those who have the book, whether so as to obtain economic benefit from its activities. Is it there in control 1? No. Control 1 only says directly or indirectly more than 50% share in the voting power of the enterprise. This control method 2 says control of the composition of the board, if it is a company form of organization. But if it is a non-corporate entity like partnership or cooperative, okay, or trust, then governing body, control over more than 50% of the governing body so as to obtain economic benefit from its activities. In this method, the objective must be to obtain some economic benefit from the activity. Why this is also a mode of control? If you control the board of directors, are you not controlling the decision-making body of the entity? If you control the council of ministers in India, are you not controlling the whole of the parliament indirectly? Because these are the 20-25 people who are actually not required. They control the country. Is it right? So if you control them, you control the entire parliament. If you control the driver, you control the car. Is it right? Therefore, the standard setter says if you can control the board, you can control the company. How do you control the board? If you can appoint majority of the board members. If you can appoint majority of the board members. Suppose board has 6 members. So 4 out of 6 can be appointed by you. Then you are controlling the board. In that case, irrespective of the percentage of shares held, you have to consolidate the other company. So your share is supposed 20%, but you can appoint 4 board members. You will have to also apply AS21. Remaining 80% will appear as minority interest. Remaining 80% we'll show it as minority interest. So one problem of this variety we will solve, where you are controlling through board of directors without holding the shares, or with holding the share, but holding of share may not be 50%. Still you have to consolidate. AS21 will become applicable. Now some more discussion is required here. Sometimes a company appoint the governing body of certain trust. Okay, like for example, basically staff welfare trust. Like gratuity, provident fund, and other staff welfare trust. So they create a trust for the welfare of employees, and they appoint generally most of the governing body members, trustees. But your objective is not to get any economic benefit out of it. Will you consolidate that provident fund and that gratuity trust also? The answer is no, because this condition is missing, so as to obtain the economic benefit. It's only for the welfare of the employees. You are not purchasing, selling, providing service, receiving service, giving loan, taking loan. So no economic activity involved. No need to consolidate this kind of provident fund trust, gratuity trust. Okay. Can we consolidate a partnership with a company? Yes, in case if you are able to control majority of the partners and for economic benefit purpose. Now what is control here? Control is established when there is a power to appoint all is always welcome, or majority of the directors or members without the consent or concurrence of any other person. That is, you can appoint majority of the board members. Student has asked this question, that how can control over board of directors give you control over the company? Simple answer. Who is the highest decision making body in a company? The board of directors. Who decides the dividend to be proposed? The board. Who decides mergers, acquisition, buyback? Board. So therefore you can take all key decisions if you can control the board. Okay, one question for you. Now you wake up and answer. A Limited is in a position to exercise significant control over the composition of partners of Messrs. XYZ and Company. This is a partnership and this is a company. You are able to control the composition of partners. Whether A should consolidate the financials of XYZ and Company? The answer is yes. The other entity need not be a company. The other entity can be any other entity. You should be able to control the composition of governing body for the purpose of getting the economic benefit. If these two conditions are satisfied, even that other entity will also get consolidated. Okay. Now this is a more tricky question. Can one subsidiary have two parent company? Can one subsidiary has two parent company? How two parent company? Okay, let us say there is company A. B holds 60% share of A. C controls majority of board. So who will consolidate A? Both will consolidate, because these are two different companies. So B, while preparing its CFS, will consolidate A. C, while preparing its CFS, will also consolidate A. Possible. This is a very rare type of situation in practice, where a person holding 60% of the share is not able to control the board members. Now, why such situation can arise? Why such situation can arise? Okay. Suppose you start a new business, startup company. Okay, you have all ideas, knowledge, technology, but don't have money. Is it right? So you acquire a venture capital. You ask a venture capitalist, you come and invest in my business. But I will keep the control because I am the promoter. I have developed these business ideas. So I'll keep 60% share. Okay. But that venture capitalist tells you, I am giving you money. My money is invested. I am taking all the risk. So I should be the major decision maker. I want four board members out of seven. Do you agree? You say no. Then I will not give you money. What will you do? Form another company. And give him 60% stake in that company. Okay, then root it. Okay. Will he agree? Will you agree? No. Okay, your idea can be discussed, but for the time being, normally you will not agree to that kind of suggestion. You would say, no, I want in this company, what is going on, I want 4 directors. And those who need money, they have to agree to such kind of demands. So they will enter into a shareholders agreement. In that shareholders agreement, they will write, venture capitalist will provide $2 billion, but he would appoint 4 directors out of 7 directors. So therefore, he gets the control through board. You being a promoter, you keep 60% share, you get control through shares. Is it right? So this problem will come for new businesses where they need money and they agree to such demands. Now next is the definition of minority interest. In this chapter we will call it minority interest. In Ind AS 110 we will call it non-controlling interest. Okay? So minority interest in simple terms would be the value of outside shareholder in the subsidiary company. Value of outside shareholder in the subsidiary company. That is what they have written. Net result of operation and net asset of subsidiary attributable to interest not owned directly or indirectly through subsidiaries by the parent. Okay. So understand. First case. A holds 60% share in B. So what will be minority interest here? 40% of the net profit and 40% of the net asset. So in the P&L account, 40% of the profit of subsidiary will calculate and transfer it to minority interest. And in the balance sheet, 40% of the net asset we will calculate and show it as a minority interest. Okay, one more example. A holds 60% in B. Then A holds 20% share in C. B holds 40% share in C. Tell me what is the minority interest of B in percentage and minority interest of C in percentage. A is holding 60% in B, direct subsidiary. So minority interest of B will be 40% of net asset and net profit. What about C? A is holding 20, B is holding 40. So A plus B together are holding 60% share. Simple calculation, 40 plus 20. Do not apply over intelligence, 60% into 40%. There are 100 shares of C, 40 is owned by B, 20 is owned by A, so 40 is owned by outsiders. So minority interest of C will be 40% of net profit and 40% of net asset. It is shown separately in the P&L account, profit part, and the net asset is shown separately. This shows that this is the value of the outside shareholder in the subsidiary. Suppose this value comes to 2 crore rupees. In the balance sheet, 2 crore rupees is appearing as minority interest. It means the outsiders are holding shares whose value is 2 crore rupees. Okay. Of course, this is based on the book value. So, it may not be the correct valuation. For correct valuation, you have to apply the chapter valuation of shares. Is it right? Which is not in your syllabus. In FR. But it is there in SFM. So, at least you got the idea. If I want to acquire this 40% share, how much I have to pay? Approximately. Because it may be more or less 2 crore rupees. Is it right? Because as per AS 21, generally the accounting is based on book values. Book values do not represent the true value of a company, because true value is based on goodwill, brand, and other intellectual properties which are not reflected in the balance sheet. Is it right? So therefore they will have to negotiate, but at least you got some idea. What is equity? Equity means net worth. And how do you compute it? First I'll read the definition. Residual interest in the assets of the enterprise after deducting all its liabilities. Now in mathematical terms, you will be given a balance sheet. Let us say this is the balance sheet of subsidiary. Okay, equity, share capital, reserve and surplus, assets, liabilities, and some miscellaneous. Nowadays it won't appear, but in case if it is there, miscellaneous expenses not yet written off. So how do you compute the net worth? There are two ways you can do it. One is you take equity, share capital, add reserve and surplus minus miscellaneous expenses, if it is given. Or there is one more way you can reach that magic number. Can I also say it is equal to assets minus, you can write if it is not printed, assets minus liabilities. Equity equal to assets minus liabilities. Most of the time we are going to use this mechanism because balance sheet will be given to you. But sometime we have to use this equation also to reach the equity figure. Equity means net worth of the subsidiary here. If minority interest is 40%, 40% of net worth is the minority interest. Is it right? So at some point of time in our questions, we will require the definition of equity. Equity does not mean equity share capital. Equity does not mean only equity share capital. It means share capital plus reserve minus any miscellaneous expenses and losses. Okay, now next three definition quickly. Parent. Who is a parent? The company which controls one or more subsidiaries. In how many ways you can acquire control? Two ways. One, through voting rights, more than 50% share directly and indirectly. Second, composition over the board of directors in the case of company or a governing body in case of any other enterprise. Who will prepare CFS, parent or subsidiary?
Parent.
So we have to prepare CFS of parent. What is group? Group means parent and all its subsidiaries. Does group include associate? Yes. Parent and subsidiaries. Where I have written associate? Group means parent and subsidiaries. Not. It does not include associate. Clarification given by ICAI. Yes, Institute had issued one FAQ list long back, and there they have mentioned it does not include associate. So shares held through associate will not be counted while calculating the control, but shares held through subsidiary will be counted while calculating the control. Is it right? For example, A holds 20% share in B. So B is an associate. B holds 60% share in C. Whether C is a subsidiary of A? The answer is no. Because B is not a subsidiary. Control is through subsidiary, not through associate. So this is not an example where A can say that C is my subsidiary. Okay. Then what is a CFS? CFS means financial statement of the group presented as those of a single enterprise. So CFS format is also same like your separate financial statement. Only one more line item will appear, that is minority interest. In case if you are holding less than 100% share in a company, if you are holding 100% share in a company, then even the minority interest will not appear in that question. Is it right? So now we will take a break. Break is for 10 minutes only.